happened that October 17th falls on a Wednesday, and you know, my film is done. And I guess it's also Bea Alonzo's birthday. It's also Inam's birthday, and everybody is a part of this project. So why not?
Okay, so the universe inspired.
Exactly.
So you were telling us kanina, no, na nakaiyakan kayo, no? Or nakaiyakan si Aga and Shirley.
That's right.
And yeah. Even Tony, no? Why so?
I guess the film has a lot of heart. Literally and figuratively, the film is all heart. And I guess through my pitch and through the story you're about to see, it really just pierces through the heart. And you just can't help but cry. Parang natural lang pierce. It's nothing forced. It's quiet. It's like a whisper. And the next thing you know, you just find yourself so emotional. That's why I thought the film was worth telling. The concept, the story, is just full of heart.
It's a pretty daring move on your part to understand the film.
It's definitely a first time. First love for me is a lot of firsts. Not just this kind of genre, classic, you know, romantic drama, love story, which, you know, the Filipinos love, right? But also working with you know, the Aga Muhlach, I mean, an icon, you know, somebody I've always dreamed of working with, to finally get him to say, yes, let's do this. And then to add a Bea Alonzo, you know, one of the best actresses of her generation, to put them together and to go to Vancouver and shoot this film, I'm only now experiencing and feeling just kind of how big this all was, you know, because, you know, I was just like, wow, you know, what an opportunity.
It's based on real people, a real situation.
Well, it's of course it's a fiction, but it's based on truths, meaning that the story of Nick, the story of Ali, it can happen. And we did our research, meaning we talked to doctors, we talked to a lot of the top heart doctors here in the Philippines and also in Vancouver, just to make sure that the story we're telling is it can happen. And they told us it can happen. And that's why I said, okay, well, then this story must be told.
Okay. So how did you take on Aga Muhlach?
I just listened to him. I mean, he was my teacher, you know, he was like my older brother. He made me feel so comfortable. I mean, he never at any moment made me realize that, hey, you know, you're working with you know, me. I've been doing films, you're not even born yet. He was so collaborative, and he's literally a genius. I mean, he'll probably deny that, but he's a genius, and that's why he's the best at what he does. His crafting, his characterization, his work ethic is just, I've never worked with anybody like him.
Yung bawat ano no cadence ng
exactly,
ng
I mean,
dialogue nagbibig may ibang meaning ibang voice kanya.
No, exactly, the collaboration that we had per scene, the discourse and the debates that we would talk about, and when he finally got into character, it was just flawless, smooth. But what else do we need to do?
I mean, say much.
Aga Muhlach. And then you pair him up with, you know, one of the best actresses among her generation, Bea Alonzo, who's just proven herself over and over again. I seriously, sometimes I just, you know, would kind of just pinch myself and say, you know, what am I doing here? But I embraced the opportunity, I seized it, and we have a film.
So, dapat maganda yung birthday gift sa'yo. Or should I say that dapat maganda yung birthday gift sa'yo?
Yes, well, I hope so. Usually on my birthday naman, I like to give, and I'm going to give you all a movie. I know you're going to have to pay for it, but let me guarantee you that it's going to be worth every peso. I mean, it's Aga Muhlach, it's Bea Alonzo, it's Vancouver. It's a great classic love story. It's quiet. It hits you at the right time. It hits you when you don't expect it.
Okay.
And that's what I hope you all experience in October.
How was Sandy? I ask because she's gone through so much also.
Yeah, no. Tita Sandy, is, of course, is, you know, Sandy Andalong is Sandy Andalong, and she's worked a lot with my wife in Home Sweetie Home. So finally get to work with her. I got to work with Tito Boyet, Christopher De Leon in Dupont. So it was finally nice to work with Tita Sandy. And yeah, I mean, because of her experience in her life,
the truth in her life,
she actually would bring a lot of tears to our set when we would talk about where she's gone through. And we were, I think Aga and Bea were able to also embrace that emotion. And me as a filmmaker, I was able to see it also from the perspective of someone who's actually lived, you know, these kind of stories. And you know, for her to give me that strength and it was you know, admirable of her, and you know, Sandy was just fantastic from day one. And, she plays the mother of Bea here, and I think she was also able to help Bea's character.
May twist to the story, no? Which we're not ready to.
Well, yeah, there's a definitely a surprise. There's definitely a surprise. It's something that I want you to experience in cinemas.
Sobra naman. Sobra twist naman.
It's a twist I feel that will pierce your heart. That's the one I think that made my wife cry, made Aga, Charlene, Bea cry. I think that was it. And that's what I want you to experience in the cinema, and that's what I hope is worth your 200 pesos.